WWE Hell in a Cell advertised Bobby Lashley versus Drew McIntyre for the WWE Championship inside Hell in a Cell, in addition to the SmackDown Women's Championship to be defended inside the Hell as Bayley challenges Bianca Belair. Hell in a Cell also advertised Alexa Bliss versus Shayna Baszler, Kevin Owens versus Sami Zayn, Cesaro versus Seth Rollins and Rhea Ripley versus Charlotte Flair for the Raw Women's Championship. Friday's broadcast of WWE SmackDown, featuring Roman Reigns versus Rey Mysterio inside Hell in a Cell, garnered an overnight rating of 1.928 million, which is up 4.1% from the overnight rating the week before. WWE Raw garnered a viewership of 1.742 million. At first, I thought Bayley was paying homage to Mick Foley with her red vest, but it turned out she was just trying to coordinate with the Hell in a Cell. The flames on Bianca Belair's gear were reminiscent of Harlem Heat and Kira Hogan. Michael Cole introduced the phrase, haircuff, to describe Bayley tying Bianca Belair's hair to the bottom rope. Bayley tried a spot with kendo stick during last year's Hell in a Cell that she eventually gave up on, so it was good to see her try it again and succeed. Pat McAfee was a virtuoso on commentary, and his ability to make this feud seem exciting was just him showing off. Michael Cole awkwardly pointed out that Seth Rollins has a history of delivering injuries to people's eyes. Shayna Baszler's response to being asked about a doll by another grown woman, Sarah Schreiber, was so perfect, as she demanded that Sarah never say the name of that doll around her again. Now that Alexa Bliss can hypnotize people, you have to deal with the harsh reality of this woman winning a world championship with her eyes. For more on this polarizing match, click here. Kevin Owens was basically Humpty Dumpty throughout this entire match, suffering through one injury after another with the referee threatening to stop it multiple times. This match really benefited from friends being able to hit each other harder, because Sammy bled the hard way and at one point they were literally punching each other in the face. Given this match's intensity and violence, it came off as more of a blow-off match than any of the Hell in a Cell matches. I don't think anybody's wrestled each other in life more than Ko and Sami Zayn, and their ability to still have a very unique match in spite of that is incredible. One fan in the Thunderdome displayed the words, "Here for Rhea Ripley," on their phone, and another fan who even made a Rhea Ripley sign. Charlotte was great throughout this match as a trash-talking heel. In a match between two heels, with Rhea Ripley pretending to be a babyface, the pretend babyface got herself disqualified. Bobby Lashley held up one finger to signify Drew McIntyre's last chance, and Byron Saxton astutely pointed it out. WWE, and the announce team, did a good job treating this like a big match.